हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू ओंथुमन सिनेमाथमेटिक्स चैनल। सो इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियो ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ प्रोबेबिलिटी फ्रॉम क्लास 8। नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी विल गोइंग टू स्टार्ट एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी सजेस्टेड सम दैट टू गो थ्रू द सॉल्व एग्जांपल ऑफ आर्यसावर्त मैथमेटिक्स बुक। In this video, we will going to learn about exercise 24A of R.S. Agarwal, R.S. Agarwal math book. Related to the chapter probability. So let's start. Let us take the first question. Now in the first question, it is given that a coin is tossed. What are the possible outcomes? So in the first question, so if a coin is tossed, so we know the possible outcomes are: one coin is tossed, so the possible outcomes are either head or tail. Okay, so these are the possible outcomes. Next, this is one Roman one. Next, Roman two. Two coins are tossed simultaneously. What are the possible outcomes? So if two coins are tossed, the possible outcomes are head tail, next tail head, next tail. These are the possible outcomes. Okay. Next, question number 3. Roman 3. That is, a die is thrown. What are the possible outcomes? So if a die is thrown, possible outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are the possible outcomes. Next, four, from a well shuffled deck of 52 card, total 52 card are there, one card is drawn at random. What is the number of possible outcomes? So we can choose one card from this 52 card by 52 ways. So the possible outcomes are 52. Well, to understood it, the possible outcomes are 52. Next, move to question number 2. The question number 2, it is given, I am just reading the question. In a single throw of a coin, what is the probability of getting a tail? So that's easy, that's I have already solved in my previous, getting a tail, getting a head. Okay, hope you are able to understood it. Next, move to another question. So next, in a single throw of two coins, find the probability getting both tail, at least one tail and at most one tail. This is question number 3 of R.S. Agarwal, exercise 24A. So in a single throw of two coin, so the samples, the outcome should be head, head tail, and tell. Now first is both tail So let T be the event which describe both tail. So probability of T, that should be total number of outcomes, that is 4, and both tail, in one outcome there will be both tail, so 1. So probability of getting both tail is 1/4. Next, at least one tail, let A be the event which describe at least one tail. Now at least one tail means here we can see that in three cases, this, this and this, in these three cases tail occurred, 1, 2, 3. So here one times, here one times, here two times. So at least one tail. So probability of A, or probability of A, that's equals to number of favorable point to A, that is 3, at least one tail divided by 4. So that's equal to 3/4. Next, at most one tail, let B be the event which describe at most one tail. So probability of B, that should be at most one tail, in two times there should be one tail, head tail and tail head. So at most means in these two case we have to take, so 2/4, that means 1/2. So that should be the answer. Okay, in this case though the answer is not matching with RS Agarwal, but I will later discuss it, but in my opinion it should be 2/4, that is 1/2 should be the answer. Okay, next move to another question. Next move to question number 4. Here it is given a bag content four white ball and 5 blue ball. B for blue here, 4 white and 5 blue ball. They are mixed thoroughly. So if they mixed, so total number of ball that should be 4 + 5, that is 9. Total number of ball is 9. Now if one ball drawn at random, so if one ball drawn at random, what is the probability of it is a white ball? So let W be the event which describe that the drawn ball is white. So probability of W, that's equals to a total number of white ball is 4, so 4 should be in the upper, and total number of divided by total number of ball is 9, so 9 should be in the lower. So that should be the answer. This is the first answer. Next, a blue ball. Now again, let B be the event which describe that the drawn ball is blue. So probability of B, that should be 5/9. Okay, so that should be the answer. Next, move to another question. That is question number 5. I am reading the question. Question number 5: A bag contains 5 white, 6 red, 4 green ball. One ball is drawn. What is the this is quite similar to the question number 4. We first add 5 white ball plus 6 red ball plus 4 green ball together. Okay, row number of ball is 15. So in my denominator there should be always 15. In case of white ball it should be 5, in case of red ball it should be 6/15, in case of green ball it should be 4/15. Okay, next, move to another question. In a lottery there are 10 prizes and 20 blanks. A ticket is chosen at random. What is the probability? This is quite similar to the another question. So total 10 prize are there and 20 blank. So total number of ticket lottery is equal to 10 plus 20, that is 30. So if a ticket is drawn, if a ticket is total number of lottery ticket, so if a ticket is drawn here to the net random, what is the probability of getting a prize? Now getting a prize, in favor of getting prize there should be 10 ticket, okay, and total number of ticket is 30. So probability of getting prize, that should be how much? 10/30, that is 1/3. Next, move to another question. That is question number 7. It is known that a box of 100 electric bulb contain 8 defective bulb. One bulb is chosen out of random in the box. What is the probability the bulb drawn is defective and non-defective? So the total number of bulb is 100, that and 8 are defective. So obviously 92 are non-defective. 92 are non-defective. So if a bulb is chosen, then it should be defective. The probability of defective, that should be how much? 8/100, okay, and probability of non-defective, that should be how much? 92/100. Now if you calculate, you have to simplify it, you will get your answer. This is question number 7. Next, move to question number 8. Obviously we are following exercise 24A, RS Agarwal mathematics book. Now a die is thrown at random. Find the probability of getting a 2, a number less than 3, a composite number, a number less than 4. So if a die is thrown, so total number of outcomes would be 6 here. Now in the first question, getting 2, the probability of getting 2 is the 1 point. Okay, in favorable to 2 there should be 1 point, that is the 1 2 3 4 5 6. So in favor of 2 there should be 1 point. So 1 should be there, divided by total number of outcome 6, so 1/6. Next, a number less than 3, getting number less than 3, so that should be 1 and 2. Okay, So 2 points we are getting. So 2 by 6, that means 1 by 6 would be the answer. Next, a composite number. Now, how many composite number are there? 3 composite number, 2, 4 and 6. Sorry, 2 is not composite number, 4 and 6, these 2 are the composite number, 2 is a prime number. So, probability of getting a composite number that should be in favorable to that, 2 points are there, 4 and 6, divided by total number of points, that is 6, so means 1 by 3. Next, a number less than 4, that is also easy. Number less than 4, there are total 3 numbers are there. The probability of getting a number less than 4, that should be 3 by 6, that is 1 by 2. Okay. Next, question number 9. Question number 9 is a survey of 20 ladies. It has found that 82 like copies and 180 dislike it. From these ladies, one lady is chosen. What is the probability the lady is dislike copy? It is very similar and very easy. So, students, you can try it yourself. Next, move to question number 10. Question number 10, it is given a box contains 19 balls bearing 1, 2, 3, 19 respectively. A ball is drawn at random from the box. Find the probability that it is a prime number. So, for that, we have to write 1 to 19. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 9. Total 19 we have to write. Next, in the first question, it is told that the prime number. So, probability of getting a prime number. Getting prime number. Or we can denote it by an event A, and we can write it that P of A. Her A is the event of getting prime number. Now, here prime number is 2, 3, then 5, 7, then 11, then 13, then 17, then 19. Total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 prime numbers are there. So, getting prime number 8 divided by 19. So, that should be the answer. Hope you are able to understood. Next, an even number 1, even number means this 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, these are the even number. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So, there are, so probability of getting even number, that should be 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9 divided by 19. So, that should be the answer. Next, number divisible by 3, a number divisible by 3, 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, these numbers are divisible by 3. The probability of number divisible by 3, that should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 by 19. Hope you are able to understood. So, this is the first answer, this is second, this is third answer. Okay. Student, one thing here. Here we have to compute that in question number 4, probability of getting a number not less than 4. So if we have to find less than 4, that should be 1 by 2 a, okay. Now not less than 4, that is 5 and 6 should be not less than 4. So that for that the probability should be 2 by 6, that should be 1 by 3 will be the answer. So this is one answer, this is one answer, this is one answer. And if it asked that the probability of getting number less than 4, then 1 by 2 should be one another answer. But for the book's question, these three are will be the answer, okay. This you have to omit right now. Next, question number 11. Question number 11, it is given the one card is drawn, a well shuffled deck of 52 card. Find the probability of the card drawn is a king. Now we have to know that in a well shuffled deck of 52 card there should be 4 king card, 4 king card, okay, 4 king card. And and total number of card is 52, obviously 52 card. So probability of getting a king, the probability of getting a king, that should be number of favorable point to getting a king, that is 4 divided by 52, that is 1 by 13. Next, a spade. Now as we know that total number of spade is equal to 13, there are 13 spade. So probability of getting a spade, that should be 13 by 52. Total number of spade is 13 over 52, that is 1 by 4. Next, a red queen. Now we have to know that in heart and diamond, there should be two red queen, okay, there should be two red queen. Rest of the red queen should be spade and club, and that color is black, so we don't have to count that. So here probability of getting a red queen, so the red queen, the number of favorable point to the red queen is 2, that is for diamond and heart we will get the red queen. So 2 divided by total number of card, that is 52, that is 1 by 26. Next, a black 8. Now in case of spade, in case of spade and club, okay, spade and club, these two are the black card and these two are red card, these two are black cards, okay. So since these two are the black cards, so getting a black 8, so total number of favorable point to getting a black 8 is 2 divided by total number of card, 52, that is 1/26. So 1/26 would be my answer. Next, question number 12. Okay, question number 12, I am not solving right now. You try it yourself. If you are unable to solve, then it should be homework. Okay. Thank you. And please do subscribe the channel. Thank you.